Welcome to another Tutor Short provided by the Educational Support Services Department of Lehigh Carbon Community College in Snecksville, Pennsylvania, which is just outside of Allentown. These videos review key learnings for the science courses provided here at LCC. And please remember that the Educational Support Services Department does provide walk-in tutoring 5 days a week.
All right, so now we're going to talk about the cessation of a muscle contraction. First, we're going to need to get the calciums right here off the troponins. So we have these calcium pumps on the sarcoplasmic reticula. These calcium pumps work as a suction using ATP, and they will pull the calcium from the sarcoplasm back into the sarcoplasmic reticulum. So once the calcium is off the troponin, the tropomyosin then is able to cause, there's a configurational change of the tropomyosin, and it moves back over to its resting spot, covering the myosin binding site on the actin, preventing the myosin heads from binding to the myosin binding site on the actin. The calciums are then sucked back into the sarcoplasmic reticulum, where they are stored until the next action potential comes through. Then we want to stop the action potential from occurring. So there will be a reuptake of the acetylcholine back into the axon terminal through a process called endocytosis. Also, there is an enzyme called acetylcholine esterase. Which breaks down the acetylcholines left in the synaptic cleft. We also have sodium potassium pumps located on the sarcolemma. And these sodium potassium pumps, just like the calcium pumps, need ATP in order to work. For each ATP, two potassium ions are transported into the cell, and three sodiums are transported out of the cell. And this is in order to keep the electrical chemical gradient and reset the cell for the next action potential to follow. So these are the sodium / potassium pumps.